do some microscopic observation and identify some of the possible to you.
Yes, ma'am.
So, yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am. Aim of the experiment is to prepare the stained slides, and then we are going to identify some microorganisms. So today we will identify few of the fungi, algae and bacteria and observe them under the microscope. Now coming to the procedure for the preparation of the slides. So if you are going to do your experiment like microscopic observation of an fungal culture, and this is a beautiful experimental steps what we can follow in order to identify them. So first what we do is that we take a small quantity of the fungal culture from a culture plate. Okay, then you have to take one glass slide. To the center of the glass slide, we are supposed to keep one dye. And the dye what we are going to use is lactophenol cotton blue stain. So this is the dye what we are going to use over here. So you take a clean glass slide and you place in the center of it a drop of this dye, which is the lactophenol cotton blue stain. Okay, and now what we do is that from the fungal culture plate where you are able to see these fungal culture, using a good needle or by using the inoculation loop, you are supposed to transfer some cultures from the fungal culture onto the lactophenol. You have to just drop some cultures on top of it. Okay. Now, when you're transferring the cultures from the fungal culture plate onto the stain, be very careful that don't give any harsh rubbing across the slide, because the fungals are very sensitive. The hyphae and all which is present may undergo some breakage. So, very carefully we have to transfer the fungal culture onto the dye. Once we have finished that one, we have to tease in the sense spread the mass gently while mixing it with the stain with the help of two fine needles to get the hyphae separated uniformly without much overlapping and masking the clarity of observation. So that is why this step, when the first step we are performing, you have to be very careful. And please remember that for the bacterial cultures, we are going to heat fix the microorganism, whereas for the fungal culture, that step is not at all required. So we just take the stain on the slide, and then we have to drop some fungal culture into it, and then spread it evenly on the slide, and then you have to place a cover slip. So glass cover slips are available, which can be round in shape or can be square. So very carefully we have to place it on the slide. So when you are going to place it, we have to place it over the mixture by touching one edge and slowly releasing to prevent any air bubbles which may interfere with the observation. So once we have placed the cover slip, now we can observe the slide under the microscope, initially at the low power, that is 10x, and then turning it into the high power, that is you can magnify it up to 20x or 40x depending on the clarity of observation required. So these are the steps what we have to perform, provided the cultures from where you are starting is going to be the fungal cultures. Now in case if you are going to use algal cultures, then the procedure is same, but a slight difference is there in the mounting reagent. For example, you just prepare the slide, same thing, from the media or from the cultures, you take the algal cultures onto the slide, and then you're going to add the stain. So you just have to take the slide, mount it with iodine. For algae, you can use iodine, or just in water also, you can drop the algal cultures, and then you can observe them initially at low power and then at the high power, that is 20x or the 40x. So for algal, because the size of the organisms are a little bit bigger, so at 40x itself, the second magnification itself, we'll be able to locate the organ. organisms. Okay. Now, if it is bacterial culture, as we have seen already, how we follow the steps for gram staining and using the primary stain and the secondary stain or the counter stain, we can use the bacterial cultures for the gram staining procedure to observe the microorganism. But here, initially, you have to focus for bacterial cultures 10x, then you have to locate the organism, then you have to shift it to 40x, and at 100x, by using oil immersion, you're going to identify the bacterial cultures, whether they are gram positive or gram negative. So once you have prepared all the slides by using these procedures, then you can identify the organisms by observing under the microscope to identify, because each one organism will have some characteristic features. By that one, you are able to identify them. So I'm going to now give you about individually about all the fungal cultures, then algal culture, as well as the bacterial cultures, how you are able to observe it under the microscope and how to identify. Yes, this is the slide which is showing us the particular fungal or an algal or even an bacterial organism. So if you take rhizophus, it's under classification, you can see that the kingdom is Mycota, division is Eumycota, subdivision is Zygomycotina, then it is class Zygomycetes, the order Mucorales, then family Mucorales, and the genus is Rhizophus species. Now, this is how actually the picture of the rhizophus will be observed. So you can see that this is the mass what you're able to find. Okay, we call it as the rhizoids, from where all these branches are arising, which we have labeled them as the sporangiophore. Okay, on the top, you're able to see bulb-like structure, is it not? So that is called as the sporangium. Okay, so now you can see that there are some on the sporangium, on the top, you'll be able to see some spores, which will be getting released from the sporangium. Okay, and this is a little bit bigger in size. They are called as zygosporangium. Okay, now how to identify it? There are certain important features which differentiates the rhizophus from the other fungal species. So first point, remember that rhizophus is a saprophytic fungus. It is also called as black bread mold. It grows on the surfaces of moist carbohydrate rich foods as a contaminant. The mycelium is aseptate. That means when you see this mycelium here, which is there, it is not been divided or segregated. Whereas we see that form of a septum in the case of the Aspergillus. So this is one difference which will clearly differentiate us between the rhizophus and the Aspergillus. So the mycelium is aseptate and profusely it is branched. So you can see the branches over here, which we don't find it in the case of the Aspergillus. It has root-like structure, which is called as the rhizoid. So that is what I showed you. You can find here a bunch of structure which is arising from here. So that you call it as the rhizoids. Opposite to these rhizoids, rhizophores or the sporangiophores are present in clusters. Asexual reproduction of this fungus is by fragmentation and also by the asexual spores. Sporangiophores are the structures of asexual reproduction. The tip of the rhizophore bears the sporangium and contains dark to pale spores with a large columella. The spores are oval and they are unicellular. The spores are liberated on the of spores. Now take the sexual reproduction. If you take the sexual reproduction, it is by homo heterothallic gametangial population. So with these characters, it can be identified as a rhizophus species. It is used to produce industrial products like fumaric acid, lactic acid, a few of the enzymes, mainly by the process of fermentation. So these are the features about the rhizophus species. Now coming to the second fungal category, which is called as the Aspergillus. It is also coming under the kingdom Mycota, division is Eumycota, subdivision Ascomycotina, class is Euascomycetes, order is Eurotales, and the family is Aspergillaceae or Trichomaceae. Then the genus is Aspergillus species. So this is the picture what you are able to see the Aspergillus. So you can see how completely it is different when we compare with that of the Rhizophus. So you can see the septum over here. You can see the septum here. There are no any branches over here. Then this is the hyphae and you find the conidiophores. Okay, there we call it as the sporangiophore. Here it is called as a conidiophores. So the arrangement of the conidiospores, you can see on the top you are able to see the spores which are present, and this small section is called as the philodiles, and the larger region from where all these philodiles and the conidiospores are rising is called as the mitulae. Okay, now coming to the features about the Aspergillus, the mycelium is septate, whereas Rhizophus we saw it is aseptate. The conidiophore arising from the food cell has no septa. The conidiophores are distinct, terminated by a swollen vesicle bearing flask shaped philodiles. Okay, then philodiles may be borne directly on the vesicles or on the intervening mitulae. Then spores are developed at the end of the philodiles. Then spores are single cell and are arranged in basipetal succession. What is the meaning of basipetal succession? That means the younger spores are at the base while old ones are at the terminus. Then asexual reproduction in this organism is by conidiophore spores, and sexual reproduction is by sclerotium formation. With these characters, we are able to identify the given specimen to be as the Aspergillus species. Now, Aspergillus species are industrially very important for the production of organic acids and enzymes like alpha amylase, lipase, protease, cellulase, etc. Some of the Aspergillus species are plant and animal pathogens and are also observed as contaminants in few of the food and the vegetables at home. Now, coming to the third category of the fungal cultures is the Penicillium cultures or the Penicillium species. The kingdom is Mycota, division is Eumycota, subdivision is Ascomycotina, class is Euascomycetes, order is Eurotales, and family is Mucoraceae, and the genus is Penicillium species. So this is one of a picture which has been shown regarding the culture of this penicillium. Okay, so you can see the hyphae, then the conidiophore, and the conidia you can find over here. So it is like a brush like head, which is a little bit different when you compare with that of the Aspergillus. Okay, now coming to the other features about the penicillium, it is also called as blue or the green mold, commonly found as contaminant on the bread. The hyphae are septate and freely branched. Then vegetative reproduction is by fragmentation of the mycelium. Then conidiophore is septate and branches at the tip to form the mitulae. Then these mitulae will give rise to philodiles on which the conidia are borne. So these conidia are the spores, are single cell and arranged in long chains with the youngest spore at the base of the chain in the basipetal order. The conidia in long chains on repeatedly branched conidiophore resemble a brush-like head, which is a characteristic feature of this Penicillium species. Asexual reproduction is by sclerotia and conidiospores. With these characters, you can identify the Penicillium species. It is industry of the production of penicillin and other important products. Now coming to the next category, Saccharomyces species, then the kingdom is Mycota, division is Eumycota, subdivision is Ascomycotina, class is Hemiascomycetes, order is Saccharomycetales, family is Saccharomycetaceae, and genus is Saccharomyces species. So this is the one of a picture where you can see that the east picture you're able to see, especially the Saccharomyces. Now when you're seeing the east and the bacteria, you may get little bit confused with this bacterial, which is a spherical type of bacteria. Now very clearly if you observe the east, it is oval in shape. That is the first difference is what your aorta. They will not be spherical. They will be oval, and in the center you can see that bulging will be there. So that clearly tells you that the given sample is the yeast culture. And if you very keenly see here, you can see the budding also, which has been started in the case of this yeast organism. Okay. Now there are very important features about the yeast. It is a unicellular fungus having a single nucleus than X, because in bacteria you have to focus under 10x low, and then 40x, and finally to 100x, where you get 1000 times magnification, and also you have to put oil immersion. But for the yeast cells, since their size is larger, at 40x itself you can very clearly see the cell with their nucleus. Then the cell size ranges from 1 to 5 micrometer in width and 5 to 30 micrometer in length. Shape will vary from spherical to oval, and budding is often seen in the cells. Flagella are absent, but the cell possess most of the eukaryotic structures. Yeast reproduce asexually through budding. Sexual reproduction is by spore formation. It is identified as yeast Saccharomyces species. Yeast are very important organisms in food and fermentation industry to produce several products like bakery, alcohols, wine and beer, etc. Some yeast are also used as products as like probiotics also. Some yeast are also used to produce recombinant DNA products. So these are about the yeast. Now coming to the next one, spirulina. Phylum is Cyanobacteria. Class is Cyanophyceae. Order is Spirulinales. And family is Spirulinaceae. And the genus is Spirulina species. Now the features about the spirulina is that it is a genus of blue-green algae. It is used as a nutritional supplement. They are microscopic fresh water organisms and also known as cyanobacteria. Their color is derived from the green pigment, which is chlorophyll, and also the blue color from a protein which is called as the phycocyanin. The most commonly recommended for its use as a nutritional supplement are Spirulina maxima and Spirulina platinus. They occur in warm, alkaline, salty and brackish lakes. Spirulina contains many important nutrients like B-complex vitamins, beta-carotene and linolenic acid, and also it contains good amount of iron, then calcium, magnesium, manganese, potassium, selenium, zinc, bioflavonoids and protein. So that's why spirulina is being considered as one of an important source for the production of the SCP, single cell protein. Then coming to the bacteria, which we have already understood much about the how to identify them by using the gram staining procedure. So Bacillus species are here gram positive rods. So the kingdom is Bacteria, the class is Bacilli, order is Bacilles, family is Bacillaceae, and the genus is the Bacillus species. Now these are cylindrical or rod shaped cells which will be focused at the highest magnification of 100x. The cells are blue or violet in color, that is depending on the stain, that is a crystal violet, that is a primary stain, whatever we are adding to it. The length to width ratio varies from genus to genus. It is identified as a bacterial organism, that is a Bacillus species. It is gram positive. After staining the bacterial cultures, it divides in one single plane to produce a bacillus, streptobacillus to form a chain, and then coccobacillus also. The average bacillus size is ranging from 0.5 to 1 micrometer in width to 1.4 meter length. Coccobacillus being so short, assemble cocci only. A chain of bacilli is called a streptobacilli, and the genus of bacillus is used to produce amylases and several other industrial products by fermentation. Then last one is the Staphylococcus species, which is coming the positive cocci, which is in form of inches. Okay, bacteria, Bacillus is its class, Lactobacillus is the order, then Staphylococcaceae is the family, and Staphylococcus species is the genus. Now these are small spherical cells, blue or violet in color, arranged in irregular order like a grape bunch. cultures which are positive, so you can identify them as the Staphylococcus. So the division is in random planes, that's why you are able to get the bunches, grape in the form of the bunches. That is how they will be appearing even when you focus it under the 100x. The average size of the coccus is about 0.5 to 1 micrometer in diameter. Many of these Staphylococcus species are pathogens and they can cause skin and wound diseases, and also they are one of the important agents which will be causing the pus near the wounds. They can also cause lung and throat infections, and one of the important species which has been studied thoroughly is the Staphylococcus aureus, which is the most common pyogenic bacterial pathogen on skin, wounds and burns, etc. It grows on the nutrient agar to produce round colonies with different colors depending on the species. There are certain pigments which are produced by these organisms, but they are not diffusible into the medium. So these are the list of fungal, algal, as well as few of the bacterial cultures, organisms, how you will be doing the staining and how you can identify them with few of the characters what I have listed down. Okay, so this is the reference book which I have referred in order to prepare the slides. Thank you, students. And now we will continue with the demonstration of how to do all these few of the organisms.